Hello everybody. So today we will continue to learn chapter 1, Introduction to Reinforced Concrete Structures. In the previous lecture, I have introduced you the introduction of design reinforced concrete structure course, and we discussed about the objective structure content of the subject and the assessment and examination of the subject and learning resources and reference standards. Today we continue to learn chapter 1. So in chapter 1, we will have 10 parts. The first part is about practical meaning of the subject. The second part of chapter 1 is working principle between concrete and reinforcement. The third part discuss about classification of reinforced concrete structures. The fourth part is advantages and disadvantages of reinforced concrete structures. And the fifth part is application fields and development strengths. The sixth part is physical mechanical properties of reinforced concrete. And the seventh part is content and steps to design reinforced concrete structures. Next, we will go to the eighth part, case of load, internal force, and combination. The ninth part is computing method of reinforced concrete structures. And finally, principle of basis composition of reinforced concrete structure. So at first we will study the first part, practical meaning of the subject. So after finishing the course, you can understand the work design calculation of test or test the bearing capacity of reinforced concrete components. For example, bending or tension or compression components. And this subject as the basis for learning higher subjects in reinforced concrete groups, such as the reinforced concrete 2 and the reinforced concrete number 3 for high rise building. Or you can learn other subjects such as design of structures subject to earthquake load, or for the graduate level, you can study advanced pre-stress reinforced concrete structure. And moreover, you can have the knowledge to implement two subject projects of reinforced concrete 1 and reinforced concrete 2. And initially get acquainted with the paths in the graduation project. Next is the working principle between concrete and reinforcement. At first, the concept. So reinforced concrete is a complex material made by concrete and reinforcement. And concrete is composed materials, and it consists of sand, stone, cement, and water. And they will form an artificial stone. And the quality of the concrete depends on the quality of composing materials, manufacturing methods, and maintenance mode. About the history of using materials. In the history, human has used many types of construction materials, such as rock and wood. For rock and wood, they have been used for thousands of years. However, for steel and concrete, they have used over 200 years. So, steel and concrete mostly has been used in the modern urban architecture. For example, they are used in house, office, bridges and roads, or even in water supply and drainage systems. The complex system of infrastructure has contributed to the development of the world economy. So about the history of using material of concrete and reinforced concrete. So you can see here, in Italy, they use the concrete from the year 70 to 80, and in France they use for the bridge in the year about 50 AD, and in 1774 they use the concrete for the India docks in England, and they use the cement in the water. And in 1824, the Portland cement has been invented. And from the 1849, the reinforced concrete has been used. And in 1895, the monolithic reinforced concrete has been used, and this is how the reinforcement are distributed in the beam by Heidelberg, and this the reinforcement are distributed in the column by Heidelberg. And in 1928, the pre-stressed reinforced concrete are invented. So we go to the working between concrete and reinforcement. At first, we see the properties of concrete. Concrete is a material with very good compressive strength. However, it has a very poor tensile strength. So in calculation, the tensile strength of concrete can be ignored. And you can see here the tensile strength of concrete. RBT is only 1/15 to 1/10 of the compressive strength of the concrete. About the reinforcement. Reinforcement is a very good compression and tensile strength. And the compression and tensile strength almost the same. Here we have an example. The concrete B15 has the compressive strength about 8.5 megapascal, and for the steel A1 it has the tensile strength and compressive strength about 225 megapascal. However, steel is an expensive material. So because of the properties, concrete has a very good compressive strength, and reinforcement have good compressive and tensile strength. So people come to the idea that reinforcement is put into concrete to create reinforced concrete structure. In particular, compressive stress is subjected to by concrete and steel, and the tensile stress is bear by steel to create reinforced concrete material with better bearing capacity and superiority. Reinforcement is placed in concrete not only for tensile strength but also for bending, twisting, cutting, compressing at the the center and off center. When arrange the bearing load reinforcement, the cross-section size, the structural shear weight will be reduced, while ensuring high strength to the structure. So here we have an example of bending reinforced concrete components. For example, here we have a single beam with a fixed ends and a roller. And here we have a vertical load. And these two vertical loads, P, will create a moment, a bending moment, M. And it causes the beam bend like this. And the upper part of the beam, we have the compressive stress. And in the lower part, we have the tensile stress. So people will arrange the reinforcement in the lower part of the beam to resist the tensile stress. So what is the difference between the left model and the right model? For left model, we have the reinforcement is not so much. However, in the second model, in the right model, we have the reinforcement is quite much. And this, the left model is a plastic destructive with less steel. And in the right model, which much or is steel, we have the brittle destructive. So we have to calculate to determine the reasonable reinforcement and place the reasonable reinforcement in the area of tensile resistant concrete. That is the compressive reinforced concrete components. So we have two column model. And these two columns model bearing the combination of loads include moment and the axial force. So if the moment is fixed, it will be the large eccentric compression column if the moment is big, and the reinforcement to be calculated and arranged like in this section. However, if the axial force and is big, then we will have the case small eccentric compression column and the reinforcement will be calculated and arranged in the perimeter evenly in the perimeters of the sections like this. So we have to calculate and place the reasonable reinforcement in the both areas, tension and compression resistant concrete. So yes, a question here. Why concrete and reinforcement in reinforced concrete can cooperate to bearing load? So here we have four reasons why concrete and reinforcement can work together to bearing the load. The first one is due to the adhesive force between concrete and reinforcement. The second one is there was no chemical reaction between concrete and reinforcement. The third one is concrete protect reinforcement against corrosion. And the final one, concrete and reinforcement have almost the same coefficient of thermal expansion. So here is the adhesive force between concrete and reinforcement. the elastic force is equal to the cement creep force, and it takes about 25%, plus the friction force, about 75%. And here we have the ankle length. This is the reinforcement, and this is the concrete. And we have a tensile force and here, and you can calculate the stress diagram. Stress diagram of the friction. So reinforced concrete can withstand loads due to the friction. The friction here between concrete and reinforcement. And we can calculate the ankle length. This is the ankle length. It's about 15 to 20 diameter, the diameter of the reinforcement. Here is the corrosion of steel in concrete. Usually, the reinforcement will be put inside the concrete. However, if the concrete appear the crack, for example, here we have the concrete appear the crack. So the moisture and the penetration of oxygen and chloride will go through the concrete and contact to the reinforcement surface, and it can penetrate through concrete and penetrate through glass and contact to the reinforcement and to create corrosive products. And when the corrosion happen here, the volume of the reinforcement is expanded and the cracking is widened and the corrosion continue. Here is the example for the consequence of corrosion in the bridge pier. So in design, we have to calculate to ensure the thickness of the concrete, and the reinforced concrete protection layer must be thick enough, and depending on the external environmental properties, and we must ensure and calculate the thickness of the concrete. And this is the reference you can see. The third part of the chapter 1 is the classification of reinforced concrete structures. So according to the construction methods, we will divide the reinforced concrete structure into three groups. The first group is monolithic reinforced concrete, then the precast reinforced concrete, and the semi precast concrete reinforced concrete. And according to the mass, we can classify the reinforced concrete structure into heavy concrete, which the average density about 22 to 25 kilonewton per cubic meter. And for small grain concrete, we have the average density about 18 kilonewton per cubic meter. And for the light concrete, we have solid or hollow structure, and we have porous concrete and special concrete like cell stress concrete. And according to the stress test, we can divide the reinforced concrete structure into two groups, normal concrete and pre-stress concrete. So this is some figure, some pictures about the using the application of the monolithic reinforced concrete. For example, here we have the multi-story building or high-rise building. They use monolithic reinforced concrete. And here, for multi-story building, they have the precast reinforced concrete. And also here is the precast reinforced concrete are used in constructing the multi-story building. And here they use the precast reinforced concrete to construct the supermarket or the factory. So the precast reinforced concrete, that means they are manufactured in the factory and then transport to the construction site and they do the connection. They do the connection to form the final building. And here is the precast reinforced concrete for apartments. So we continue to learn the four parts of the chapter 1, advantages and disadvantages of reinforced concrete structures. So the advantages of reinforced concrete is the use of local materials. For example, sand, stone, grit, gravel. And this material are available and easy to find, easy to use. So this is an advantage point. And reinforced concrete have greater bearing capacity than stone and wood type structure, especially resistant to large movement. And reinforced concrete material can withstand dynamic loss, including earthquakes and explosions, and it can sustainable over time with low maintenance costs. And it's difficult to catch fire, so it has good fire resistant capability. And depends on the shape. Reinforced concrete can create any shape according to architectural and aesthetic requirements. So those are the advantages of reinforced concrete. And here is the disadvantages of reinforced concrete structures. The first one is the great cell weight. That means the reinforced concrete structure cell weight is very heavy, about 1,800 to 2,500 kilogram over meter cubic meter. So it is difficult to make a structure with a large span, long span. It's very difficult. So we have to think about the solution. The solution for this disadvantages is to use the lightweight concrete and we stress concrete or thin cell structure to reduce the cell weight of the reinforced concrete structure. The second disadvantage of reinforced concrete structure is the poor soundproof and heat proof. So to avoid this disadvantage, we use porous reinforced concrete structure. And the third one is the complex construction work and long time. So to reduce the time for construction work, we use the precast reinforced concrete structure, precast. The final disadvantages of reinforced concrete structure is easy to appear cracks, and the crack will cause the quality and aesthetic damage. So in that case, we will use the distress structure, or we calculate the limit stage to limit the width of the cracks and the length of the cracks, and we use the fiber reinforcement. And here is the summary table for the advantages and the disadvantages, and this is the solution for each disadvantages. So you can list by yourself and try to understand. The fifth part of the chapter one is the application fields and development trends. There are many application fields of reinforced concrete structure. For example, we can see in civil and industrial engineering, or road bridge and transport station, or irrigation, and even in special engineering like defense structure or nuclear power plant. For the development strength, we have many research, like the research on new concrete materials, and they do the research on extremely high strength concrete with the strength bigger than 80 megapascal, or the bending concrete is another research strength. And there are many modern laboratory equipment with special sensor or large scale structural laboratory to do the experiments. And we develop new method on analysis and calculation of internal forces and design of reinforced concrete structures. So here we have many development trends for the reinforced concrete structure, and here we have many application fields for the reinforced concrete structure. For example, in civil and industrial engineering, this is an application field. We use the reinforced concrete structure for civil and industrial engineering. For example, here is a high-rise building in Ohio State in the United States. And for another example, we have the Opera Sydney. The Opera Sydney in Australia is also constructed by reinforced concrete, and it has the length about 183 meters, and the width about 120 meters, and the area is about 1.8. And for the assembly hall of the Illinois University in the United States, is also constructed by reinforced concrete. And here is the example for high-rise building, Water Tower Place in Chicago, USA. And this building have the height 262 meters with the 74 stories. And this is the TV tower in Toronto, Canada, with the height 553 meters. And it's also been constructed by reinforced concrete. And here is the Petronas Tower in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. It was built in 1992 and completed in 1998. With the height of 452 meters with 88 floors. And here is the another high-rise building in the Shanghai, China. And even the Dubai Tower also has some parts of a structure that's built from the reinforced concrete structure. And this is the Hoover Dam in the United States. It's very long and big dam with the length about 379 meters and the height is about 221 meters and the thickness vary from 14 meters to 183 meters and the total volume of concrete is about 2.5 million meter cubic meter. This is another example of the application of reinforced concrete. And in Vietnam, this is an example of the using reinforced concrete. So you can see many the example for the application fields. And this is the tunnel in Japan, second tunnel in Japan, and it connects to Iceland of Japan, so it's very long, about 53 kilometers. And this is the channel through the Manch Channel. And it connects the France and the United Kingdom. And this tunnel also built from the reinforced concrete. And here's the example for the researching reinforced concrete. For example, here's the bending concrete. You can see here is the concrete plate which have the capacity of bending. And here's the example for large scale structure testing. And here they are testing a column with the height about 3 meters and the cross section size about 100 and 350 millimeters. And this is the experiments with the many sensors. Here is the strength design. And according to the old standard of concrete of Vietnam, and we use the linear elastic analysis to calculate the force, concrete internal forces. And this for plastic design. We use plastic design analysis to calculate the force, concrete internal forces. And this displacement-based design. This was developed from 1990 for seismic design of reinforced concrete structure. This is the force and this the displacement of the structure. And we can calculate the building damages directly related to the strength. So, this is the end of the 1.5 of chapter 1.